And a new way to get around in the South Bay. The nation's first self-driving shuttle is now taking passengers. Only on 5, KPIX 5's Kiet Do has climbed on board, and he joins us live with a preview. Hey, Kiet.
Yeah, we are live here inside the RO self-driving shuttle. Check this out. There's nobody in the driver's seat here. They don't even have a steering wheel. You know, today was my first time in a self-driving vehicle. It's a weird mix of excitement, anxiety, and fear, and then it all kind of just goes away. And that kind of is the point.
At Santa Clara University, walking to class is so basic.
You guys are the very first passengers.
Seriously? Oh my God, seriously? That's insane.
It's the first day the public gets to ride Aro, an autonomous self-driving campus shuttle, the only one of its kind in the country.
Wait, why are you not Snapchatting this right now?
But I wasn't sure because you were filming if I should like have my phone out.
Main perception and localization is all done with our LiDAR up top.
The shuttle is equipped with LiDAR sensors for a 360-degree view. Walk in front of it and the system knows a human is trying to cross the road. What makes RO different is that they've captured a 3D map of the route, and then the shuttle drives around in that virtual world. RO almost always yields the right-of-way to make pedestrians feel welcome.
When I saw something come out in front of it, it just comes to a complete stop and waits for that obstacle to clear. So when I saw that happen, I was like, okay, these guys know what they're doing.
So it really feels like a human driving it, like nice, courteous human driving it.
However, teaching it to be assertive, like in a crowd of people, is hard. When things get hairy, the operator takes over manual control with a joystick. Eventually, the computer will learn what to do on its own.
So over time, it'll be near perfect, do you think?
Oh, for sure, yeah. Because eventually I won't be here, so it'll have to be perfect.
RO hopes to equip other college campuses and large companies with a fleet of on-demand shuttles.
What's your message to people who fear the future?
Come take a ride. Once you will take a ride, you won't fear anymore.
Are you ready to ride the future?
For Frank and Linda Falby, giving up control to a machine was actually easier than they thought.
No, I think the move to the technology is inevitable. So I think, you know, it's kind of like once it's out there and the ball has started rolling, there's no way of stopping it. I mean, this is, I believe, is probably the future.
So here is the cool thing. This is open to the public, so if you want to come take a ride in a self-driving vehicle, you can do so. Come to the main entrance of Santa Clara University Monday through Friday, 9 to 12, and then 1 to 5 p.m., and then 9 to 12 on Sunday mornings. And they're going to be doing this until February. And we're live in Santa Clara. Kiet Do, KPIX 5.